What's going on, everyone? This is Mr. Senior, 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 Junior, Senior, Dave K here today to talk to you about health and fitness. And when I say health and fitness, I mean fitting his whole pizza in my mouth.
Dave, no, we're not talking about fitting the pizza in your mouth. This one's just about actual fitness. Just fitness.
Oh, you don't want me to talk about fitting his whole pizza in my mouth this time?
Right.
That's for next time, then, next time?
I'm not so sure about that, Dave.
Some other time, then. Some other time.
Probably not.
Okay, some other time, we'll talk about fitting this whole piece in my mouth. But today, I want to talk to you about health and fitness. Pizza in my mouth. What's going on, everyone? Dave K here today to talk to you about fitness. And you may be asking yourself, you may be saying, Dave, you know, with all the theme parks closed and natural parks closed and beaches closed and pretty much everything closed, how am I going to stay healthy and stay in shape without being able to go outside? Stay healthy while staying inside? That's a great question, and I want to address that with you here today. Now, from a health perspective, there's obviously pros and cons to this. You know, maybe you can't get as many of your steps outside, do your 10, 20 miles. But also, maybe you're eating less Dole Whips or churros. I know, at least for me, I'm eating less Dole Whips and churros. And so hopefully that's helpful on that front. But maybe now you've got some recipes for churro bites or Dole Whips or, you know, night blossoms and stuff like that. And you're saying, okay, now I'm eating this stuff again. Where's my exercise coming in, Dave? I need to know how I'm staying healthy, staying fit while staying inside. Give it to me. Well, one of the first things I like to start it off with, if you're trying to do some fitness at home, I know cardio can be on the trickier side, so one of my preferred things to start it off with, if you have the chance, is to do stairs. If you have stairs, walking up the stairs can be good for you, heart health-wise, you know, cardiovascular health-wise, also in terms of leg muscle size and wise, and you want to make sure that you're getting that cardio in that way, so I think stairs could be good, and if you can do not just one steps at a time, but two steps at a time, that'll really build some like heavy duty exercise if you feel like one step at a time is too easy for you. Now you may be saying to yourself, Drill Sergeant Dave, I mean, Dave, what if I don't have stairs in my house? How am I supposed to do that cardio workout, those leg workouts without stairs? Well, that's a great question. I'll tell you one thing that I've been doing if you don't have stairs that I like to do every day is squats. I do free weight squats, so I don't have any free weights. I do free body weight squats, where I'll just kind of hold my hands together, that sort of thing, and do squats. So you can just kind of squat on your own if you're familiar with how to do that. If not, you can also look up kind of directions as to how that's done online. But squats is a good kind of workout, whether you have weights that you're using or not. If you've never done squats before, try just doing free body weight squats there. And that can be a great way to kind of start building those leg muscles towards squatting and start building some of that cardiovascular health in that way. I feel like if you get more of those full body exercises like squats in, that can be a good way also to kind of build that cardiovascular health and build those leg muscles and also to build your booty. And yes, I said booty. All kidding aside though, for now, I feel like squats are a good way to get started in terms of if you're just looking for some at-home workouts for that overall full body health. And another one for me that I like to do every day, you may or may not already know this, maybe I've said it enough times already, Dave, or maybe I haven't, and I like to do push-ups. For me, I try to get that push-up in my daily routine. I feel like that's good for building the pecs, for building just arm muscles, but I feel like it's a good, quick, and easy home exercise that I can do. I've been doing it for so long, it just has to remain a part of my routine. So squats and push-ups, both are part of my daily routine now, in addition to one more exercise. Speaking a little bit more to push-ups though, again, Drill Master Dave, what if I can't do a full push-up, or I can't do push-ups like you're doing them? Well, there's a couple of strategies for this, make life a little bit easier for you in terms of push-ups. One thing that you can do is kind of like a reverse incline push-up. So depending upon what angle you're at when you do a push-up can make it harder or easier. So for example, as you may or may not already know, if you kind of do a push-up against a wall, there's almost no exercise to that, right? If your hands are on the wall, you push yourself towards the wall. It's almost just like leaning, right? Whereas if your feet are up on the wall and your hands on the ground, makes for an extremely challenging push-up, right? So think about it that way, where maybe you want an incline where your hands are up on a couple of stairs. You know, you're a couple stair levels up with your hands, and your feet are down on the ground, maybe makes a push-up a little bit easier for you. Another way to do an entry-level push-up is you can do push-ups on your knees, so you're not lifting your entire body weight, but just kind of from the knees upward. It's less kind of surface area to lift in addition to less weight. So doing push-ups from your knees can make that a little bit easier for you as well as those kind of reverse incline push-ups. If you don't, again, if you don't have the stairs to use, maybe you do push-ups on like your bed where your hands are on your bed and your feet are on the ground. Again, kind of a reverse incline push-up there, whatever works for you in terms of incline. And if you have other ideas for the incline as well, I'd love to hear your thoughts. Now, that third exercise that has become a daily part of my routine is ab exercises. This, for me, I want to work on my abs. I think this is an opportunity for me to try to get a little bit more lean and mean as a fighting machine. So I'm trying to do my daily sit-ups and that sort of thing. There's a variety of different way to do sit-ups, crunches. You can do reverse crunches. So for example, instead of kind of lifting the top part of your body towards your feet, you can lift your feet back in towards the top part of your body, depending upon which kind of muscles you're trying to work on there, what's easiest for you. There's other leg exercises you can do as well, kind of in that similar position, so that you can start working that same kind of area. And this bicycle kicks is one of them. I like to do bicycle kicks, where it's kind of like you're kicking your feet in kind of that way where it looks like a bicycle while you're sitting on your back to build some ab exercise there. Again, depending upon what works best for you. Now, I know some people have mentioned, oh, this can be a little bit painful for me on my back. And I can run into issues with this from time to time too, depending upon what kind of floor you have, especially if you have a wood floor or that sort of thing, tile floor, you might run into some issues trying to do sit-ups there. So a couple of suggestions for you on that front. One, maybe you want to find a lighter floor if you've got some carpet somewhere, see if that'll work out for you. Another option that you've got there is a floor mat. If you have some sort of floor mat or something you can lay out on the ground, maybe it's a comforter or some thick blankets, you can do some ab exercises there. And another thing on that front in terms of, well, you don't have enough comforter to make it comfortable enough, maybe you can do those ab workouts, again, kind of on your bed where you're laying your back on the part of your bed where, let's say I'm doing those reverse sit-ups, my knees are off the bed and they're coming towards my abs, but my back itself is on the bed, so I have a softer surface to do that workout on. Now, this can lead to kind of an easier workout than if you're just doing it on a very level and hard floor, especially if you're talking about a bed when compared to a carpeted floor or something along those lines. So that's just something to keep in mind for you as well. Make sure you understand kind of the impact on that, on the intensity and the severity of your workout. And I know a lot of people are not going outside for their walking, for their biking and their running and that sort of thing, and I can definitely not blame you for that. I'm pretty much not going out at all either. So if you're looking for a little bit more cardio in addition to the stairs, another thing you can do, there are a couple of different aerobic workouts from kind of like jumping jacks to running in place, kind of like high knees and that sort of thing. There's a, what is it called? I think it's called a burpee, an exercise I used to do for some of the sports that I did in terms of it's kind of like a jump and then you go down to the ground and push up. And so you can kind of combine some of these exercises together to make more intensive routines, again, in the comfort of your own home or in a smaller space where you can't get outdoors and be exposed to everything else going on. Now, touching a little bit here on the food side, let's speak to that a little bit as well. I want to mostly target this one on exercise in terms of the fitness perspective, but I want to touch a little bit on the food as well. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm still eating that pizza. Like, that pizza, I'm still gonna eat it. That's gonna happen. So don't think that strictly what you eat makes you what you are, who you are, that sort of thing. But there are several factors to consider on this one. Now, obviously, what you eat is important. I think it's one of the most important things. I think it's, personally, I think it's even more important than exercise. But I've built what I eat so nicely into my day where I don't touch any candy or any sugary, unnecessary added sugary items or that sort of thing.
But Dave, I just saw you try one of those churro bites Mike made recently.
Yes, yes, I do occasionally try the sugary item in that sense, but it's extremely rare for me, special occasions and that sort of thing. And it, for me, I feel like I've even developed to a point where it kind of makes me uncomfortable to eat the sugary item. Like my throat feels kind of itchy, almost like I'm getting sick after I eat something sugary and I have to kind of wash it down with water, tea, proteins, that kind of thing. So my diet, fortunately, my diet has become pretty strictly targeted around cutting added sugars and that sort of thing. But that doesn't mean that that's what works for you, you know? Everyone has their own routine, their own solution that works for them. But one of the things I like to do is cut sugars. I'm sure you've heard me say in other videos, one of the things I like to do is cut caloric beverages. generally, especially sugary caloric beverages. I'll still drink milk and that sort of thing, but I, again, try to cut any added sugar drinks. Like, I don't drink any of your sodas or that sort of thing, especially sodas or alcohol for me. Haven't had any of that in a very long time. Again, special occasions, that sort of thing. Maybe I will, but most of the time, I don't. And here's another thing. You may love all delicious items, and you don't want to cut sugars, and you don't want to cut sugary drinks, or that sort of thing. And that's all okay, because there's a way to make that work, too. For you, I personally don't count my calories. Awkward. But you can count your calories in order to make that work. So you can eat whatever you want and just make sure that you're eating a reasonable amount of it throughout the day. So maybe you say to yourself, all right, I don't want to eat any more than 2,000 calories today. Even if I'm drinking sugary beverages, I'm just going to take that off somewhere else. So I'm making sure I'm getting the proper nutritional content. And it does depend on you personally in terms of your weight and just kind of your metabolism and the way you're built, how many calories you should eat in a day. That 2,000 number I threw out there was just a kind of spontaneous average type number. But again, it depends on you and what works best for you. So there's several ways to manage the food and the diet thing, and that's why I touch on that piece in terms of kind of briefly. There's several different ways that you can look at it, but those are a couple of thoughts that I have when it comes to eating those healthier items. Because I'm still eating my pizzas, I'm still eating my hot dogs, and I'm still eating all that good stuff right there. I'm just saying, it's not like I'm getting a huge dosage of vegetables or anything. Probably should, but what you gonna do? So, to tell you a little bit more about what my routine looks like right now in terms of the exercise, I am currently at time of filming, my routine looks like approximately 90 push-ups, 30 sit-ups crunches, and 10 squats as the baseline per day. Those are easily attainable, and I'm gonna do more than those in a day if I can. 50 sit-ups, for example, today. I'm starting to do 15, 20 squats going on, so trying to raise those numbers a little bit. I've been doing the push-ups for a long time. When I first started doing it, it was 50, or maybe it was less than that when I first started doing it. Maybe it was more like 20 or 30 when I first started, but at this point, it's been years every day with the push-ups, and that just makes it so easy to keep increasing that number. So that's the secret here that I really want you to keep in mind. Like most things in life, it's a process. And little work very consistently over an extremely long period of time, for me, is far more valuable, far more essential than crazy work on one day of a week and then nothing the rest of the week. Which is why I, for example, don't really have a gym day. I just do my push-ups, my sit-ups, my abs every day. Not in a crazy amount, but to an amount where I'm feeling like, oh yeah, I'm getting some kind of exercise in here, but I'm not totally dead for a whole day trying to regain that energy and trying to rebuild that fitness. But again, depends on what works best for you. So what do you think of this video? Do you agree with me when it comes to some of these things that you're eating and some of this exercise that you're doing? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. And do you like this new funny, silly way that I've added some funny, silly thoughts and adventures and faces to these videos? Love to hear what you think in the comments below. Thanks so much for being a part of the fun with me today. If you haven't already, consider hitting that subscribe button. And ringing the bell to stay informed. And until next time, play on. What's going on? Now there are obviously... So to tell you a little bit about more... Thank you.